Hello everyone, this is David, and today I'm going to be, taking another trip down memory lane with more sing-off reactions for you. So today we're going to be doing Street Corner Symphony, their first three performances. Let's get right into it. They're my favorite from season two.
We are Street Corner Symphony from Nashville, Tennessee.
The group has a unique background. We all appreciate the roots from bluegrass to Southern gospel.
Love is a burning thing.
We want to show everybody how a cappella can be influenced by Southern music.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. Down.
We're just some laid-back Southern guys. We like to fish and hang out, and we like to unpractice. We get together, and not only do we not practice, but we drink beer.
Hit the local watering holes.
We kind of made an art out of getting things accomplished and having fun while doing it. And Nashville's great. There's music everywhere. You just walk down the street, and every bar, there's a band. It's really inspiring to us. I mean, musicians come here to live and die.
I moved to Nashville 7 years ago, signed a record deal, and worked very hard.
Imagine all the times that you could take back.
But the label I was with, they weren't releasing anything that I was writing. Kind of been through the ringer with the music industry for a while, and this would be a really great breath of fresh air for me. I feel like this TV show reignited my passion for music. What do we better lose? We're going to be there just having a great time.
Everybody wants to leave.
What a great experience, you know, to be with amazing people, good friends, and singing songs.
We want to rule the a cappella world. And we will. And we will.
Turning on their Southern charm with Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears, here's Street Corner Symphony.
Welcome to your life. There's no turning back. Even while we sleep, we will find you acting on your best behavior. Turn your back on Mother Nature. Everybody wants to leave.
Okay, can we just talk about Chance for a second? Do y'all hear how much this man has improved over the years? Like, he's improved a lot. He's improved a lot over the years. I mean, he doesn't sound bad here, don't get me wrong, but he has improved a lot since back then. I said the same thing about Jeff Castellucci from Voice Play in, my Voice Play video of the sing-off. And, the same is true here for Chance. He's a bass here. He's a baritone for Home Free right now, but although he's pretty much a second bass for Home Free, a bassitone. But anyways, yeah. And they sound really good together. And if I recall, Street Corner Symphony was another group who got together just for the sing-off. So, it's amazing how, all these groups just get together for the sing-off, and they sound like they've been doing this for a while, and it's more obvious with some groups than with others. It wasn't as obvious with Street Corner Symphony that they had just gotten together.
Everybody wants to leave. It's my own remorse. Help me to decide. Help me make the most of freedom and of pleasure. Nothing ever lasts forever. Everybody wants to leave. There's a rule where the life of
beautiful, breakdown and transition there.
Everybody wants to. There's a room where the life will find you. Holding hands while the walls come tumbling down.
person at the end there.
Everybody wants to rule the world.
Yeah. Just brings back the memories. Like, seeing Street Corner Symphony for the first time on a sing-off, that's when I truly fell in love with the show. I was like, okay. I was like, this is going to be my show from now on. And then, you know, unfortunately, the sing-off never really gained traction. Because let's look at their most successful season, season 3, where Pentatonix won. They didn't even come back the next year. It was 2 whole years before they came back. So, you know, they skipped 1 year, then 4th season happened. Then they got canceled again. Although, actually, technically, they weren't even canceled the first time. They just skipped a year because they're like, oh. The producer's like, I don't know if we're going to bring it back. I don't know. And then, you know, they did eventually bring it back just a year late. And then gets canceled this time. And then, you know, they're like, you know what? Let's bring it back again. And then they do the 5th season on one night. One night. Like, see, let's talk about season 5 for just real quick. The Melodors. I don't think they should have won. For one thing, I think the first 2 performances, I believe they had, like, you know, yeah, I think they had 3 performances. The first 2 performances, they were okay. I was like, yeah, they sound pretty good. But, like, I didn't think much of them. And they pretty much won because of that final performance of Take Me to Church. Which was the best performance of that season. True, but the judges up until that point had been very consistent with, you know, giving, like, well, actually, first 3 seasons, it was based on, like, the finale was based on a vote from, you know, like, public vote. But, like, but, you know, season 4 on, the judges picked the winners. But even still, like, throughout the entire series, they're the ones who picked who went on and who went home. The judges were the ones who picked who went on and who went home. And they were very consistent with who went on and who went home. Like, they consistently picked the most consistent groups to go on. And I just didn't think that was the Melodors in season 5. Now, season 5 is probably my least favorite. Well, either season 5 or season 1. But anyways, yeah, I talked about that way too much. Back to Street Corner Symphony. Like, they just sound good, man. They just sound good. Like, you know, it's chill. It's, you know, they're just having a good time. They're just trying to, like, you know, they're just trying to sing. And, you know, it just sounds good. And Jeremy, he is, like, the perfect front man for them. He really is. Anyways, let's hear what the judges have to say.
All right. Thank you very much, Street Corner Symphony. Well, Ben, did they rule your world?
Yeah, y'all know some Skynyrd.
That was good. That was just really good from just the first half of the first beat, which we can all relax and just listen to music. Dynamics, outstanding. The groove was great because you don't have extremely strong basses, so you know that. Like, and then they get to be musical, so the bass singers sound really good. I have one pet peeve about beatboxes, and that's the cymbals. I don't know why, and it's not against the law, but in the bridge, when some dude walks in, he goes, psst, it's the only thing that took, like, a perfect score down on the beatbox to like 99.999, and it was fantastic. Otherwise, I mean,
he is a pretty good beatboxer, especially for this point in the sing-off. Like, first three seasons didn't have great beatboxers apart from Kevin and, you know, Pentatonix, and the beatboxer from Vocal Point was really good as well. But other than that, like, the beatboxers were just, you know, they were okay. They weren't great. Like, it was something about them, like, the snares didn't sound right. And, you know, the bass drum, the kick drum was just okay. You know, it was stuff like that. Like, it just didn't sound right. Didn't sound like a drum. It sounded like someone trying to sound like a drum. And I always forget this guy's name, the bald dude that was doing the beatboxing. But, like, he's somewhere in between all that.
The unison at the end is just a great thing to do. I'm proud to live in Nashville hearing you guys do that.
All right. Sean, what'd you think?
You know, the funny thing about this business, Jeremy, life is full of second chances. Yep.
Why you had to say it like that, man? Why you gotta say it like that, Sean? Like, don't get me wrong, I love Sean, but sometimes he can be a little full of himself, you know?
You know what I'm saying? And that's a beautiful thing that you're here tonight to, you know, yeah. You're here tonight doing what I know that you feel that you were born to do. And that's all that matters at the end of the day. All those things that happened in the past, you can throw them away now because you're here. You're on national TV. You're on the sing-off, baby. You know what I'm saying? So, but I love you guys' honesty. I love the fact that you guys are just down-home Southern cats. I just like...
I forgot he wore a yellow tie. Looks dope, though.
Sing some harmony and just hang out. And it's a cool thing, and you can tell. And you guys unpracticed very, very well.
And Nicole.
When y'all started, I was looking around to see who else was singing. I couldn't believe there was only six people up there and the instruments that your voices were making. And Jeremy, you have such a beautiful voice. Yeah. I can definitely empathize with you, having been in the business for a minute and just wondering if you're going to get your break. Oh.
I believe this was Nicole's first time judging on a show. I could be wrong about that, but that's certainly what it seems like. You know, well, not the first time, because obviously there was season one, but, you know, like, she never felt comfortable to me as a judge. Sean and Ben, they feel comfortable to me. But not Nicole. And y'all already know how I feel about Nick. He's just a weird host.
Or if people really understand you as an artist. But the most important thing is that you don't give up. So congratulations on being on the show right now, boys.
Well, we are a heartbeat away from finding out if you guys made the cut. Thanks again, Street Corner Symphony.
Of course they made the cut. All right, now, second one. Hey, Soul Sister.
There's the rules of the life of...
First time out, Street Corner Symphony won the judges over with their laid-back Southern style.
They're so easy to listen to. It's beautiful, and I couldn't believe there was only six people up there.
Help me to decide.
And it was also a special evening for Jeremy Lister, who after years of struggling in the music industry, finally found his place.
All those things that happened in the past, you can throw them away now because you're here. You're on national TV. You're on the sing-off, baby.
This is a breath of fresh air. I feel like I've caught my breath again.
Here's the thing about Jeremy. Like, if I knew him in real life, I probably wouldn't like him. Because, like, you know, he's that dude that wears sunglasses indoors. Like, he's that dude that, you know, might come off as, you know, a little arrogant and, you know, tries too hard to be cool. But when he's on TV, it works. It works. Like, he's probably not completely like that in real life, because, you know, TV likes to overemphasize certain things, certain traits about, you know, things like, you know, they're gonna focus on one thing and, you know, really try to glom onto it. But, like, you know, he's probably a cool dude in real life. But, you know, like, the way he's portrayed on TV is just like, if I knew him in real life and he acted like that in real life, I probably wouldn't like him. But, you know, like I said, he's probably different in real life. I never met the dude. Probably would like him in real life, you know. If I met him, because he's probably not really the way he's portrayed on TV. But, you know, or I should say this, like, they exaggerate how he's portrayed on TV. You know how, you know, reality talent competitions do it.
Some great friends, and loving it.
The song we're performing is Hey Soul Sister by Train.
There's a lot of big moments in this song, but the chorus needs to be huge, so we decided we would go for these outrageously high notes.
Hey Soul Sister!
It's very, very high, and...
See, that just goes to show, it's not easy to do this stuff, man. It's not easy to do this stuff. Like, that's why you practice and practice.
It's gonna be difficult to do it justice. Tonight.
Or on practice. See, already the bass line sounds better in this than it did in the first song. You know, just something that catches my ears. Beautiful swell right there, like, you know, just great sense of dynamics.
So I went and let you go my mind. Hey, soul sister, hey, that Mr. on the radio, stereo, the way you're moving ain't bad, you know. Hey, soul sister,
now, here's the thing I love about, like, the groups on Sing Off. Like, generally, they'll have, like, multiple people who do the beatboxing. Because, like, that way, if, like, one of the beatboxers has to do the singing part, then, you know, the secondary beatboxer can come in. It's like, right here, this dude, the ball guy, he's the beatboxer. And, you know, so... the other secondary beatboxer is taking over right now, and to be honest, I don't think the secondary beatboxer is as good as this guy is here. Like it's been a long time since I've seen these, so I don't remember their names except for Jeremy, because, you know, and Chance, because, you know. But, you know, like, but even still, it still sounds good, the beatboxing. And, like, it's amazing that, you know, groups can do that. You know what I think it is about beatboxers on a sing-off? Like, for the most part? I think they try to overemphasize the bass and the snare drum. So because of that, it doesn't sound natural. It doesn't sound clean like when Kevin does it, the beatboxer from Vocal Point does it, you know, when Lane does it, when you know, Adam from Home Free does it. It doesn't sound as clean because they're overemphasizing the bass and the snare. But you know, maybe I'm overthinking it. And I can't be, I'm gonna tell the world that you do are with me. Beautiful. Like, first of all, love the breakdown section there, especially with Ball Dude. Like, I keep forgetting his name. I want to say it's like Ben or John, I think. But anyways, he was like their pretty much like their hype man the whole season, if I remember correctly. And that part where they're at the end of the breakdown, where they're, you know, it sounds like a record scratching. Well, not really scratching, but you know, like skipping or something like that. What's the right term for that? I don't know. There ain't nothing I can't be. I'm gonna tell the world that you are with me. Hey, soul sister, and then Mr. on the radio. Stereo, the way you move it ain't bad, you know. Hey, soul sister, I ain't gonna miss a single thing you do. Very well done. I feel like they were more comfortable during their second performance than they were in the first performance. And, you know, one thing I always wondered was, I don't remember them ever featuring Chance as a soloist on the sing-off. I could be wrong, but, you know, I don't remember it. And I always wondered why they didn't do that, because, you know, for one thing, he was featured in the intro package of the first song. And, you know, he sounded good. She's like, why not feature him once? I mean, I know Jeremy is a beast. He is a vocal beast, but so is Chance in his own way. Like, obviously, he wasn't as good back then as he is now. Like, his sound has matured a lot throughout the years, and you know, you can tell. Anyways, let's keep going.
Great job, Street Corner Symphony. Now let's hear what the judges think. Sean?
I thought it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun to listen to, and it was a lot of fun to see you guys actually do it. Jeremy, I love your voice. I honestly really do. And it has a purity to it. It's melodic. It's easy on the ears. And the way you guys back him up vocally, it's just very pleasant. That's what makes a good group, when everyone blends in, and even the solo has something to fall back on. And John, loved your bridge, and you came in and nailed it.
Okay, John. So he's John. So I was sort of right, because I said either Ben or John. Now I don't have to call him Bald Guy anymore.
Ben.
The blend was beautiful. The arrangement was gorgeous. I mean, the percolation as part of the groove, it's...
I'll see what I'm talking about with Ben and his musical terms. Just like I remember, like, the first time, like when I was watching, like, the sing-off, when it was live on television, I was like, what is he talking about?
It's very inventive. It was very cool. Jeremy, it was a beautiful vocal. I mean, your voice is great. And I'm... And you're a rock star. And I'm looking forward to hearing you sing a little lower in your register, so that you exude sort of, I wouldn't say a sad sense, but I think you're the kind of singer that could sing a sad song and really make it feel right. And you'll do that in your lower register, in my opinion. So.
Well, Ben, that's coming up in their next performance. Because, you know, next performance is Creep. And that was my favorite performance throughout the entire second season of The Sing-Off. See, that was a performance where I was like, you know, I think they're going to win. But, you know, like I said, Committed was, you know, a little bit more consistent than they were throughout the season. So because of that, they won. Because, you know, throughout the first four seasons of the Sing-Off, the most consistently good team won. Instead of, you know, the group that gave the best performance of the season. Although sometimes they were one and the same.
Looking forward to that. You guys rock. Thanks.
Nicole.
Okay, growing up in Louisville, Kentucky, coming from the South, there's just something so cozy and warm and cool about you guys. You guys are like the perfect little street corner combination. All six of you together, you just are perfect together. Adam, I really love your bass. I felt like just real sweet Southern laid-back bass. It sounded so good. You guys are just such a great example of why this show is so awesome and so credible, because it's about real musicians.
I don't know if you can say it's credible at this point, because this is literally the second season. But I mean, I get what they're saying, because like literally everyone on the Sing-Off can sing, like really, really sing. You can't always say that about like other, like, talent competitions. At least like singing talent competitions. But anyways, let's keep going.
It's about real talent, and you know, that's why this is gonna be the hottest show. Because it's just like you can't deny real talent.
That's right.
and real voices. So congratulations, guys.
Okay. We'll find out a little later if you'll be moving ahead. Thank you, Street Corner Symphony.
Alright, and now it's time for Creep. Come
to your life. Just a couple months ago, we were working regular jobs, just regular people, and now we're on TV.
Being here, it's like I'm in a dream in some ways. Been through the ringer with the record industry, and it's great to have a second chance to be performing for everyone.
All those things that happened in the past, you can throw them away now, because you're here. You're on national TV. You're on the Sing-Off, baby.
These guys are the most talented people that I know. It's just an honor to sing with them, and there's a lot at stake this week. So we've got to step it up a notch, because, you know, a few missed notes here or there could mean you're going home.
Oof. You know that first chord, right? Like, right there? That dissonance that they achieve there is great. And, you know, that's like the perfect start to the song, because, like, you know, it leaves you a bit unsettled. And, you know, the song is supposed to do that. It's supposed to leave you unsettled.
You in the eyes, you're just like an angel, your skin makes me cry, you flow like a feather, this beautiful world.
Just so many things happening in the background here that, you know, just, you know, make the atmosphere so, you know, ethereal and otherworldly, and that's perfect for this song. And remember, they're doing this all a cappella, which is ridiculous.
Wish I was special, so very special, but I'm a creep.
Oh. See, the beatboxing, like, in this performance was on point. Like, and it goes back to the fact that, you know, he's not overemphasizing the bass and the snare. Like, he's just trying to do it a little more naturally, you know, and it sounds like a drum set now.
Oh, what the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Oh, oh, she's running out.
Yes, yeah, Jeremy. To that entire section again.
I don't belong here.
Here it comes.
Oh, oh, she's running out the door.
Beautiful little flip into head voice there. Just gorgeous. Told a whole story arc in a minute 30 seconds to like 2 minutes. that's ridiculous. And like I said, this song right here, this performance, this is when I fell in love with the sing-off. Like, before this, I was like, yeah, this is a cool show. I was like, I wonder where it's going to go. And then I was like, okay, this is where it's going. And then, of course, he gave us groups such as Pentatonix, Home Free, Voice Play, to a lesser extent, the Philharmonic as well. Which, tell me in the comments if you guys want me to react to, like, the Philharmonic as well. Because, like, you know, they're an active group still, so I believe Street Corner Symphony is no longer active. I could be wrong about that, but you know. Anyways. But you know, like this, like I said, this was the moment I fell in love with the sing-off. I was like, this is my show now. This is my show. Because, like I've said many times before, that I love talent. Like, reality talent competitions. I know a great deal of it is, like, you know, either fake or, you know, like, extremely, you know, exaggerated. But you know what's not exaggerated? The talent. And that's why I watch these reality talent competitions. The sing-off is my favorite of all of these talent competitions, and the fact that it never really truly gained traction broke my heart. But anyways, let's keep going. Let's hear what the judges have to say. But no wait, before I do that, let's talk about this performance just a little bit more, because this was like the performance for me in the second season. And the way they did like their swells and then like, you know, coming back down was just amazing. You know, all the background stuff. The bass was on point. The bass lines were on point. The beatboxing was on point. And, you know, just so many different things happening here. And like, you know, they really set the mood for this song. Like they had like the perfect backgrounds going on for this song, and it was so good. It was just so good. And you know, their dynamics were super on point here. You know, started off quiet, you know, and built, reached the climax, and you know, slowly came back down, and then, you know, a nice quiet resolve at the end. Nice quiet resolution at the end, and it was just beautiful. But anyway. Yeah, the backbeats were pretty good. Were good during this season too. They were a little more hit or miss though than either Committed or Street Corner Symphony, which is why they got third. I think they got third, right? And this goes back to what I was saying about, you know, there's always that one group in a season, like starting from the second season, where like, you know, they're made of like a hodgepodge of like other groups from previous seasons. The backbeats were like that. Like they were part of like, some of them were part of the SoCal Vocals previously from season one. And then I think there was another college group that they were also a part of. Then Kenton, I forget which school he went to, but yeah, he was, you know, he was the guy who got brought them all together. Like they all, I believe the beatboxer of the backbeats was part of Noteworthy. Yeah, and then, you know, they're part of other groups as well, you know. And if you see this girl up front, like the blonde in the front, that is the girl from Pitch Perfect.
Thank you, Street Corner Symphony. Now let's hear.
I believe her name was Kelly.
From our esteemed judges, Ben.
Jeremy, great use of your range now. That's great. That's.
There's an understatement.
That just built the whole time, I believe. It pulled the whole thing off. Lead vocal was awesome. I thought when it hit the chorus, it really took off too. That's where the band came together. The bass and the drums sounded really good. And by the end, there was a standing ovation. It was well deserved. Mm-hmm.
Sean?
Jeremy, you did the rock star thing, big baby. I like the fact that you guys didn't have any choreography, because it would have been really cheesy and corny.
You got that right. Adding choreography to a song like this is a no-no. First of all, you really have to dig in with this song. You got to dig in. And Jeremy, he dug in. And like, you know that's another nickname that Sean used a lot with like a singer he really liked on the sing-off. Like Big Baby. Although, I think he mostly just used it with Jeremy. I don't know why he's like... I don't know why he's calling Jeremy Big Baby, but you know, that's what I kept saying during season two. I was like, why do you keep calling him Big Baby?
It would have took away from the song itself. So that was great. Like the fact that you guys stood, you locked in, and ultimately I was impressed. I like the fact that Jeremy, you let loose and you showed your range and you showed that energy that you needed to when you needed to do it, because that's one of my favorite songs too. So, you know, to do it the way you did it and to dip in and to go and And do what you did, that rock star mentality, that's what the song needed, and you delivered. Good job.
My man went down to the floor and was still delivering with them vocals. That's what I'm talking about. All right, now let's listen to the least interesting judge.
Anything else, Nicole?
Yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite songs, so I was interested to see what you all were going to do with it. I agree with Sean. I loved that you all just stood there and you just sang and you kept it very honest with your performance. Jeremy, and this is about the time in the competition when you start to do what you just did right now. So that was excellent. And boys, I don't know, I closed my eyes and I felt that your accompaniment was, dare I say, better than the original instrumentation that I heard. So
I will say about equal, but the fact that I didn't know that acapella, yeah, I'll give that statement to her. But y'all notice how she's way more comfortable now on as a judge on the Masked Singer than she was here. Like, so much more comfortable on the Masked Singer. So much more. Like, and that probably comes from being, like, on TV a lot more nowadays than she used to be. You know, she's much more well-known now, I guess. But either way, yeah.
But it was beautifully done. Thanks.
All right, thanks, judges, and thank you, Street Corner Symphony.
All right, so that's, you know, performances 1 through 3 for Street Corner Symphony. You know, they just have a really good sound. Clearly, like, them and Committed from the season, you know, Committed was the winners, were the winners. Like, they clearly had the best blend. Those two groups had the best blend of anyone from the first two seasons. And it shows. Like, it shows. Like, like, you gotta have really good lead singers, and you have to have, you know, really good blend in order to do well on this show. Either that, or you have to be, like, a really fun college group. Because, if I recall, the seasons that college groups did really well were were the odd-numbered seasons, 1, 3, and 5, because in 1 and 3, seasons 1 and 3, the runner-up was a college group. Season 5, the winner was a college group. And in fact, the runner-up in season 5 was, like, you know, had former college groups in it, if I recall. And then, you know, don't get me wrong, college groups still did well in season 2. But they didn't do well in season 4. Because 10 was the runner-ups there. And then third place was, I believe it was Vocal Rush, which was a high school group. I didn't think they should have won third. They should have got third, honestly. I thought the Philharmonic was better than them. I liked Voice Play better than them. The Acousticats ended where they should have, I think. Actually, yeah. Like, the Acousticats were the highest finishing group, college group, in season 4, which is, I think, like, the lowest, highest, you know, which was, like, the worst showing for, like, the best college group in a season. Because they got, what, like, they were eliminated at the same time as Voice Play, so, like, you know, they were 5th/6th place. Wow. Literally every other season, like, it was either like 1st, 2nd, or 3rd place. But anyways, yeah. So back to, you know, Street Corner Symphony. They just have a really good sound. You know, they're just so, you know, cohesive, especially for a group that just, you know, came together. Like, I really wondered how they would have done on season 3, because, you know, season 3 was by far the longest, like, pretty much twice as long as any other season, at least twice as long. Because, like, if you look at it, like, Pentatonix did, like, what, like, 12, 13 performances just for season 3? Something like that. That's a lot of performances, man. That's a lot of performances. But anyways, Street Corner Symphony, they just sound great. They have a really good blend. They have, you know, a strong beatboxer and a really good bass and chants there. And, you know, all of them have gotten better through time. I know, like most a cappella groups, they changed up their roster quite a bit after they left the sing-off. But anyways, yeah. So, you know, Street Corner Symphony, they always sounded great in my opinion. And that opinion has not changed. So anyways, I'm going to end it here. Oh, before I go, I do start classes tomorrow. So I'm going to be posting less often. I'm going to try for 2 reactions per week. Notice I said try. I'm going to try to do like one normal reaction. Like, you know, a normal blind reaction a week. And then like one of these where, you know, I'm doing like a nostalgic reaction, taking trip down memory lane for the sing-off. Like, my goal with that is to, you know, I want to react to all of the sing-off performances. One thing, like, for me, like, these sing-off performances are a little bit easier going for me because, you know, I've already heard them, for one thing. And, you know, it's just a trip down memory lane. It's a little more chill for me, you know. But anyways, I'm going to end it here, guys. So, thank you for watching. And, you know, leave any comments down below. And I'll see you guys next time.